When the sermon goes too long, do we turn to a different station? When things don't go our way, do we stop responding to God's blessings? These are among the rocky soils and weed-infested areas of our hearts, which keeps God's seed from taking root. What then are we called to do? We are to respond to God's call to serve his people, to be generous with ourselves, our time, and our possessions. As the offering prayer says, through your goodness you have blessed us with these gifts. God sows the seed within each of us to serve his church, to feed his people, to visit the sick, clothe the naked, and walk with our sisters and brothers around the world. God is up to something now. Are you listening? Really listening? Not to me, but to the Holy Spirit at work in you, kindling in us the fire of his love. There's a song I learned at Via de Cristo. Have you seen Jesus, my Lord? And most of us know that song. Then the refrain goes, have you seen Jesus, my Lord? He's here in plain view. Take a look. Open your eyes. He'll show it to you. My friends, take a look around. Look into the faces of your sisters and brothers in Christ. Take a closer look and see Jesus. Each of us acts as the arms and feet of Jesus. As another song goes, they will know we are Christians by our love. God is the sower. We are the soil. What is taking root in you today? With God's grace and his spiritual gifts growing in each of us, then we are not to hold back. We are to be just as extravagantly wasteful with God's gifts as he is extravagantly wasteful in sowing them in us. Therefore, we are to give of ourselves, our time, and our possessions extravagantly, building up our church to be God's arms and feet, God's work, our hands, holding back, or just simply withholding, is not an option. Holding back, or just simply withholding, is not an option. Are you listening? Really listening? Is your heart fertile ground for God's grace to be shown to others? Which recalls the hymn, Lord, let my heart be good soil. As we sing this hymn, listen to the words. Let our hearts become good soil. Pray for God to let our hearts soften so that we can become blessings to others. Let us then show the world how much we really respond to God's gift sown in us. Don't hold back. God doesn't. God the sower, risking the outcome, wasting seed, is up to something unpredictably graceful among snatchers and takers, stubborn blockheads, encroaching bullies and brutes, and sinners and saints that we all are. God's grace has an infinitely wide reach, accomplishing more than we can ever imagine. As the prophet Isaiah spoke God's words, it shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I propose and succeed in the thing for which I sent it. For you shall go out in joy and be led back in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall burst into song, and the trees and the fields shall clap their hands. May you find great joy in that good news today.